American business, it's so great and so performing. Like, they will create the conditions for the employees just for them to succeed. And I think this is what we're missing a lot in Moldova. We don't have conditions and possibilities for that, and we kind of have to fight ourselves there. But here, people are very supportive. In less or like more than 6 months, we will become citizen, and I'm very happy about this because this is going to give me more rights, more chances, and you know, I will support America with what I can. But in the same time, I feel like I want to support Moldova and show Moldova that that country creates very strong personalities. We are capable to emigrate and be successful everywhere.
So we met Tatiana in a pretty typical way, where we go out and do recruiting in schools. Tatiana already had a full career and was a college professor in her home country. So when she came, she was very focused and very determined and a little bit, we weren't really sure how to take her at first because she was so enthusiastic and so energetic, but I just loved her energy so much, and it's clearly paid off because she just dove in, did everything we asked. She went through our training program in about half the time most people do because she was just so determined, and she's been incredibly successful very quickly and is now already educating for one of our manufacturers. It's been great having her.
When we left Moldova, the crisis, like the economical crisis, it was very high, and our salaries got very low, and I was at home with my kids on the maternity, and my husband just was working, and his salary went like from to very, very low, and we were really struggling.
With Tatiana and Mihai, they're both so eager to learn, and they're hardworking. So they're just good people. They bring a good energy to our salon. Tatiana has a classic elegance to her styling.
We have people like Tatiana that work directly for manufacturers as well, and they are constantly being trained in what's up and coming and all the newest techniques. They know the what's happening with products, because as our fashions change, the products we need change. So that really helps us stay on top of it. We have another stylist that works for another manufacturer. So kind of depending on each brand's culture and heritage, you get different flavors. Tatiana works for an Australian company, so she gets kind of a different, their style is a little bit more laid back, it's more beachy, it's more consistent with their culture, where another stylist works with a brand out of the UK.
I think we would need a lot of years in Moldova to go over all the frustration that people have financial, because to keep a business, you have to invest. And I know that Moldova, to open a business in Moldova, it would be much harder than here. And another thing is that beauty field in my country is not that appreciated that here than here.
Well, I've been coming to this salon probably 20 years, and as long as she's been here, I've gone to her. And I'm very happy with her.
Why do you choose her?
Because she's so professional. Very professional. And she does my hair very nice.
She does a nice job. I enjoy her as a person, too. So.
And do you like her accent?
What?
Do you like her accent?
I love it. I love it. Sometimes I might have a little trouble understanding her, but most generally, she does very well. She does very well.
My family, personally, we don't have health insurance because this is not affordable for my family. It's very expensive. It is performant, and it's at a highest level, but it costs a lot. So we just try to be healthy, eat healthy, take care of our bodies, and not get sick.
I know it's an issue for some of my staff, You know, some of them have decided to just pay the fine instead of have health care because it's been less expensive for them and they'd rather just pay for their medical care as they've gone along. So, which is scary. It's a scary thing to do. You know, I feel fortunate. I've always had health insurance my whole life. I don't know how I would feel walking around not having that.
Either you have to be really poor to get funds from government, or you have to be very rich so you can pay yourself. If you're middle class, like middle income family, it's harder because you don't make enough to get help from government and you don't make enough to pay the insurance. So I feel as a beginners, when we first moved here, Arizona gave us food support and emergency health insurance, which was a temporary help, but that was a big plus for us because we feel more supported.